Hi, I'm Spencer Aronfeld. I'm a South Florida personal injury lawyer. Today I'm joined by my son, Nori.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, Nori, what's the question of the day?
Well, as the son of a lawyer, I try to keep up with the laws that change in your field specifically.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
But since this coronavirus, what have you noticed that has changed in the legal field?
Thanks. Great question, Nori. One of the most important changes I've seen, it involves the incarceration of people. People right now who are incarcerated even for a day, even for a minor offense, are subjecting themselves to a much more increased risk of contracting the coronavirus. So I've seen a lot of situations where jails are letting people out, or people who can't make bail. There are community funds. The LGBT Fund has a community bail fund where you can make a donation and they will use those funds to help get people out of jail simply because they can't make bail. And the LGBT community is at a much higher risk of being arrested. They're at a much higher risk of committing suicide within the first week of incarceration, as are people of color, have a much higher risk of being arrested and detained. So right now, more than ever, innocence has to be presumed, and every effort has to be made by all of us to keep people out of jail, because in jail right now, they're exposed to a much more increased risk of the coronavirus and of dying. If you're interested in making a contribution to the LGBT, did I say it right? LGBT Community Fund that helps raise money to bail people out in the state of Florida, and there's also a directory that we're going to post below for every state from Georgia to Hawaii has one of these community funds. Some are for criminal detainees, some are for immigration detainees. And those who follow what's happening in immigration right now know there is an increased interest in detaining undocumented people who are sitting there waiting to get their day in court and unnecessarily exposing themselves, unfortunately, to the coronavirus. So if you're interested in making a contribution, please do that. In addition, you know that we've been working closely with a criminal defense lawyer, Scott Kotler. Tell him what you've learned about that.
Well, we sat down for our Trust Me, I'm a Lawyer podcast and talked with him about criminal updates and criminal defense law. And he spoke with us specifically about things like the curfew and the coronavirus and what he's been doing in his own law firm in terms of, instead of being able to defend those who are what would be the usual case where he's trying to prevent them from going to prison and trying to help them out, he's actually working now with already imprisoned individuals to try and lessen their sentence and get them out of prison, which is because in prison, your chances of contracting the virus are much higher.
Absolutely.
So,
absolutely.
Yeah, just interesting.
So to learn more about Scott Kotler and his podcast with us, which was I thought was fantastic, how do people find the podcast?
You can check the description or find us on YouTube. It's Trust Me, I'm a Lawyer podcast, or on iTunes soon, hopefully, and SoundCloud and Instagram. Just Trust Me, I'm a Lawyer podcast.
Excellent work, Nori. Great question. Hopefully you guys will make a contribution. Click the links below. It's important to take care of those in our community who need our help the most vulnerable members of our community. We wish you and your family to be safe and well during this pandemic. Thanks for watching. Thank you for watching our video. Please be sure to subscribe to the Aronfeld Tri-Lawyers channel by clicking subscribe above. Be sure also to check out some of our other videos below.